celebration. That's your thing for this year. I think that's a great thing. It's going to be an exciting year. I've got a lot of BS to talk about today, but I want to look at the big picture. And I realize, too, I'm standing between you and a break, so I'll try to move through this stuff pretty quick. Pets is an exciting time. I'm really glad to see a lot of president nominees here. If your club does not have your president nominee here, encourage your club in the future to send that president nominee to Pets. There's so much to learn. I've been to Pets, geez, I don't know, 5 or 6 times, and every time I learn something new. And by the way, in my mind, the best part of Pets, you've got some great instructors like District Governor Billy and the speakers, but the best part is your meals. One of the meals, you have an assigned table seat, and you have to sit with people you don't know, which you should do anyway. And you learn so much about clubs and what they do, what works for them and what doesn't work. That's the best part of the fellowship in there, is the best part of Pets. All the stuff I'm going to talk about today, we're going to do in more detail May 19th at our district training. Please have as many of your key people come, your members even. Your directors, your membership chair particularly, because we're going to have a lot to talk about there. Also, April 27th is our all-club district conference. That's another great place. It's going to be where, Bill?
Kingsport, Tennessee.
Kingsport, Tennessee. It's a beautiful facility. It's always a great time. But this is also a great place to learn about what other clubs in our district are doing. It's a fun time also. I promise you, I'm not making this up. You've heard of how complicated our district grants are? Well, this is the organizational chart of Rotary International. And I swear, it's an official document. And they titled it, Our Complex Organization. Can you believe that? I didn't. But what's important about it is, the Rotary Club, your Rotary Club is at the top of the heap. The district works for you. So we're here to help you make the best of your year. So take advantage of us. I didn't know that when I was president. I thought I had to do all the stuff that the governor said I had to do. Yeah, Billy. And Billy's been bossing me around for years, by the way. But we are here to help you. And they control our money, too, so by the way, we do have to do that. It's kind of like my wife controls the money. But anyway. Okay, as far as I'm concerned, membership is your number one responsibility in Rotary. If you get membership right, everything else kind of goes along the way. Your membership chair. I always felt that the hardest part of my job as president was finding the right people to do the right jobs. You got to know what they're passionate about or what they will become passionate about. But keeping them motivated, and that to me is the hardest part of your job, getting the right people to do the jobs. This is in your handout, by the way. My stuff is in tab 2. This is one of the most important things I've got to say. I think getting new members is easy. And it's easy if your club has energized meetings, informative programs, and activities. Great service product. That makes it so much easier to attract people when you're really making an impact in your community. You've got to have some fellowships, some socializing, and networking. And then one of the keys, real keys, is your public image. You've got to tell your story. I've been in Rotary for about 40 years, and Rotary has always been one of the best kept secrets. We've got to change that. This is also, in my mind, a recipe for a successful club. When you go to visit clubs and you see them doing these things, you'll see that they are very successful. So if you can kind of master that slide, you'll have a great year. So where are Well, I know you're in Gallatin County, but where are you now as far as membership goes? Well, Jack and me, and we're very, very fortunate to have Billy Black. Billy's going to be teaching Jack and me at TEDS. And by the way, I forgot to mention this. If you can get to TEDS early on Thursday, there are lots of good classes. I learned a lot about Jack and me there. Jack and me is your friend. It will make your job easier. So take the time now to learn how to do it. Have you ever thought about surveying your club members? What do your members like about your club? What don't they like? Do you need to make changes in your meeting frequency? There's a lot of options you have now that you need to talk about soon. Now's the time to start thinking about how you want to do your year. All right, deputy is an important tool. And Billy, maybe you'll show this when you get there. But anyway, when you go to log in on deputy, go to my dashboard.
Yes.
Work. Okay, membership trends will show up. Make sure you click on the 5-year version of it. And what you want to see in your membership chart is growth. This is the Rotary Club, the Rotary Club of Franklin. Over the past 5 years, we've had a growth from about 70 to about 85 or more. And you notice that's an upward slanting line. If your club has one that's pretty much level, you really need to be concerned. If it's a downward slant, you really got to get going on membership. And so why do I think membership is so important? Well, it's really kind of, I'm a simple person. The more members we have as Rotarians, the more you can do. Yeah, so that's why you want to do it. But you need to look and see where you are. All right, here are five things, and this is also in your handout. And I didn't put this list together because I'm not that smart. A past district governor did. Well, actually, another.
Where would they find that?
Tab 2, it's in there. But I want to hit these pretty quick. Nothing else matters. If you get membership right, everything else kind of takes care of itself. Attrition is real. And we'll talk about, a little bit more about this in a minute. District-wide, we were at 14.6 or 8% or something like that. But 15% attrition rate, it's going to happen. Can't do anything about it. To counteract attrition, you've got to retain more members. And did you know also, the highest attrition rate is in our new members, less than a year. That's an issue too that we'll talk more about in May. Clubs need a membership growth every year. A 4% annual growth, if you have that, your club will double in 18 years. Now, one of your goals will be membership growth. I know when I was president, I put a +1. If you're really energetic, you might do a +2 or +3. But look at what 4% is and see if you can get there. That would be an ideal membership growth. Intentional strategies. Let me tell you what does not work. You stand up at your podium and you say, all right, we need more members. Y'all go out there and find us some more members. That will not work.
That's right.
Yes, we've all done it. And really, in all honesty, I don't care what strategy you use, but come up with some. We'll talk a little bit more about these in a minute. Certainly more on May 19th. But the important thing about membership, in my mind, is you've got to keep it in the forefront of your club. Talk about it, if not every week, every other week. Membership. Attrition, I mentioned that a minute ago. It's real. 14.6%. And you know, it's pretty inconsiderate of our members, but they die. We're a group of old men and their fathers. And some of our younger people are getting new jobs and they're moving. That's great.
They're women.
Yeah.
Yeah, I say men, you know. I'm an old folk, you know, but you're correct. Where would we be without you lovely ladies?
Young women, young women and old men.
I get it.
That'll get you in trouble.
That won't be the first time. Okay, so attrition is real. You've got to account for that. You've got, so to counteract attrition, you've got to retain more people. So what does really attrition mean? This is important. Find about the size of your club. If you have 30 members in your club, you're going to lose 5 members. So you got to bring in 5 members plus whatever just to stay even. A club of 50 is going to lose 8. District-wide, we're going to lose 330 people this year. That's a lot. So whatever we can do to keep people, we need to do that.
Of those 330, what's the demographics of it? Of the 330, how many died?
I don't know.
How many here are less than 40 years old? How many have...
You can find that in that, by the way. It's there.
Yes.
You can only find it in that TV if you put it in that TV. If you don't have a year of birth for all of your members, how are you going to know how many people the age of 40 left? Check the data.
Yeah, it was a preacher from the choir.
So,